what can you be doing, and how do you develop a mindset that people are like, wow, this person is diligent, they've done the research, right? They're into growth, because these are things that matter if you're going to bring someone into your organization.
Yes. Okay. So this actually is a mantra that we've actually trademarked for our science-based sales membership program. It's called clarity over closing. I'm not wearing that t-shirt today. I'm wearing the other one that's the popular, the always selling one. But it's got clarity is over closing, or clarity is greater than closing. This is what I mean by that. Traditionally, sales has this bad rep of people like these hungry folks in plaid suits selling a lemon car, trying to get that paycheck regardless of who they destroy in the process. And that's just not what sales is like today, or should be like today. And thankfully, information, the internet has made it more easy for the consumer, whether you're B2B or B2C, to understand and have clarity and information around what they're buying. So you can't really trick people nowadays, which is great. It's healthy for the industry. So what do I mean when I say clarity over closing? It means that you are more concerned about giving someone clarity about where they're at and where they want to be and how to get there than ultimately closing a deal. If that is your mindset going into any conversation or relationship, because sales is a relationship, and I relate this a lot like dating too, or any relationships. If you put your mindset, if I'm going to serve them, which giving clarity to me is serving, it's selfless, not selfish. If you want to be selfish, you'll probably be a bad salesperson. I mean, straight up, you might be able to cut it for 6 months to a year. You'll fail eventually. You've got to be willing to serve and give before you take. So that's the mindset you need to have. If you're going in thinking, I need to get me a job, you might make it. You might get it, because if you're really good, you might make the cut. But you know what's really impressive to hiring managers and sets you apart? When you have this clarity mindset over closing and getting the job or making the sale, they recognize right away that you're humble, you're a servant, you're willing to give before you take, you're humble, which comes along with coachability. I mean, these are all the qualities that a sales manager is looking for if they want to hire you. So the best thing you could do is like take this mindset, because there's a lot of tactics and plays we probably can cover today. We may get to cover some, but this is the main thing I'll say and end on this is mindset is the one thing that you can change, and that will affect your behavior more than anything. So if you start thinking this way, you'll probably avoid all the bad things that you should, and then the good things will come naturally as you just behave this way and think this way.
Yeah, I mean, I'm fired up right now, because I think the mindset that you have going into this is critical. Because yeah, you can make it for 6 months, a year, like you said, and be selfish, but it's more of a long-term play with your career. I think sometimes, especially with any job you think about, you're like, oh, well, I just need this job because it's been good for the next 5 years or whatever that is. But your career is a 45 to 60 year long thing. So if you were selfish for those 3 years, those people you worked with could be a manager in the future, could be a huge decision maker you're working with. So that's something really important to keep in mind.